Hello dear students, you are welcome in this tutorial. Students, in this tutorial we are going to discuss about what is feminism, what is feminist criticism and feminist theory. Friends, let's start this tutorial with a very simple thing, that feminism is nothing but a revolt against the unequal treatment given to women. This movement is based on the equality of women and men in the society. We find that women are treated unequal in the society and they are considered lower to men, and this emotion or this thing grown in the mind of women, and from there the movement of women started. And today's feminist movement or feminism is the direct product of 1960s women's movement. But let's think about the roots of this movement which flourished in 1960s. Friends, if we think about this feminism, its roots goes in the 1792. Mary Wollstonecraft and her book called A Vindication of the Rights of Women can be considered as the first book in this feminism, or the first feminist book, or the first feminist critic is Mary Wollstonecraft. And she discusses in this book the male writers like Milton, Pope, Rousseau, and she talks about how they portrayed women and what are the perspectives they expressed in their works or in their book. From there, the study of feminism started. We can say that this is the first feminist critic, Mary Wollstonecraft, and first feminist book is A Vindication of the Rights of Women. The next critic or next books we have John Stuart Mill, who wrote The Subjection of Women, his book published in 1869. Then we have Frederick Engels, who wrote The Origin of the Family, which is published in 1884. Then we have Oliver Schreiner, who wrote a book called Women and Labor in 1911. Next we have Virginia Woolf. She wrote A Room of One's Own, published in 1929. In that she talks about how women are treated unequally in education, how they have been imposed with motherhood, and how they are treated unequal in the family also. This essay is very significant in the study of feminism, A Room of One's Own, composed by Virginia Woolf. Then we have next very holistic name in the field of feminism, Simone de Beauvoir. She wrote The Second Sex, which is published in 1949. In this book, she talks about all types of suppressions which are imposed on the women. She talks about the biology of male and female. She talks about the cultural characteristics of women, how she is considered inferior to male or to men. All these things we find in The Second Sex. And there is a separate section in The Second Sex on D.H. Lawrence's portrayal of women. D.H. Lawrence has a very particular and stereotypical portrayal of women in his novels, and she analyzes the novels of D.H. Lawrence. So this is a holistic book, a comprehensive book on the feminism, The Second Sex. Now friends, we have next two significant critics in the field of feminism, that is Toril Moi, who wrote Sexual or Textual Politics, and she also composed an essay called Feminist Reader. And in that essay she talks about three terms regarding feminism or feminist criticism, that is feminist, female and feminine. According to her, feminist is a political position, female is a biological matter or the matter of biology, and the feminine is nothing but a set of culturally defined characteristics for women. So these three terms or these three concepts are significant in understanding how the feminist criticism works: feminist, female, and again we have feminine. So these are three different things according to Toril Moi, and she talks about the different forms of this feminism in different fields or in various fields. Friends, I am telling you the contributors to feminism or feminist criticism. The next contributor we have Ellen Showalter. Now Ellen Showalter becomes significant in this feminism or feminist theory because she also talks about the phases of feminist. She has actually divided the history of feminist writing into three phases. First phase we have feminine phase, which ranges from 1840 to 1880. And in that phase, according to her, female writers imitated the male writers. The next phase, a feminist phase from 1880 to 1920. And in that phase, women have maintained their separate positions in the writing. They have radical views. They have different views than the male writers. And they have their own things to incorporate into their writing. And the third phase, we have female phase, which is from 1920 onward. And in that phase, we find that again, women have changed radically and they have shared their experiences, their views in their own writings, and they have talked about style, matter, content, different types of things in their writings. So here, Ellen Showalter says that these are different phases through which we can study the feminism or the feminist literary criticism. Ellen Showalter becomes an authoritative figure in the field of feminism because she has studied the feminist writers or the female writers, and she composed a very fine book based on her research, A Literature of Their Own, British Women Writers from Bronte to Lessing, published in 1979. The second book she wrote, The New Feminist Criticism, Essays on Women, Literature and Theory, published in 1985. Her next contribution to the field of feminism is that her term called gynocritics. She coined this term gynocritics, and according to her, gynocriticism or gynocritics are those critics who study the books written by women, which are called as gynotexts, and androtexts are the books written by men. So this is also a significant contribution to this field, gynocriticism. And from there, we find that gynocriticism, a separate branch in criticism, has emerged. So the credit should be given to Ellen Showalter. Here we have a statement from her essay called A Room of One's Own. Let's read the statement and understand what is the view of Ellen Showalter regarding this feminism or feminist theory. Shakespeare had a sister, but do not look for her in Sir Sidney Lee's Life of the Poet. She died young. Alas, she never wrote a word. She lives in you and me and in many other women who are not here tonight, for they are washing up the dishes and putting the children to bed. They need only the opportunity to walk among us in the flesh. Friends, from this statement, we can say that how she talked about the inequality of women, the treatment given in the literature to women, how they are considered inferior, and hence she is talking about Shakespeare had a sister and she never get the popularity as Shakespeare because she had to wash the dishes and make children sleep in the bed, and so that she could not become so famous as Shakespeare is. Now friends, we are moving to the last section of this tutorial, that many critics and scholars have divided the study of feminism into different waves. We find that there are first wave feminism, second wave feminism, third wave feminism, and now fourth wave feminism. So let's take a look at these waves in brief. The very first wave feminism, we can approximately put the dates of the beginning of first wave feminism from 1792 to 1949, from Mary Wollstonecraft to Simone de Beauvoir, from a vindication of the rights of women to the second sex. And in this phase, we find generally women revolted against the common rights in the society, and they wrote about that. The second wave of feminism we can consider from 1949 to 1980, and in that we find that women have continued with their fight against the rights in the society and the treatment given to them in the society and family. And friends, regarding the second wave of feminism, here we have a statement of Raman Sheldon and others. Second wave of feminism and feminist criticism are very much a product of, are shaped by themselves, helped to shape the liberationist movements of the mid to late 1960s. Although second wave of feminism continues to share the first wave's fight for women's rights in all areas, its focal emphasis shifts to the politics of reproduction, to women's experience, to sexual difference, and to sexuality as at once a form of oppression and something to celebrate. Friends, from this statement, it is evident that how in the second wave of feminism, it is shifted to the different types of feminisms which are there in the first wave of feminism. Now, friends, here we have third wave of feminism. In third wave of feminism, we find that feminism has started its entrance into the micro level, and there we find that there were revolt against the domestic violence and different kinds of inequalities in the society. The same line of fight against inequalities continued in this phase also. And we have Toril Moi, who wrote Sexual or Textual Politics, which is published in 1985. And in this particular book, she talks about different forms of feminism. Now, friends, we have last phase or last wave of feminism, that is fourth wave, which is we can consider started from 2000 onwards. And in this wave, we find that again this micro level feminism continued, and the fight against inequalities in the society and male dominant or a patriarchal society continues. We have a very famous example in this last phase, that is #MeToo campaign worldwide. We find that in this campaign, women talk about the sexual harassment and how they were oppressed in the places of work. This has been very evident from this #MeToo campaign. And this is the phase where we find that the very huge form of feminism in the society. And we find in different phases, there are different types of feminism shaped. For example, liberal feminism, radical feminism, humanistic feminism, and different types of feminism. So, friends, this is all about feminism. Thank you very much for watching.